Hey guys, welcome or welcome back. If you're just joining us, basically on the last video we did a bit of a skin retouch, which was basically just how to find and remove all those pesky little blemishes that you can see. If you've not watched that, I'm going to go ahead and link that above. But in today's video, I'm going to show you a little secret trick to getting perfect eyes. Okay, so we've got eyes in this image, right? They're great, they're fine, but the highlights in the eyes are not brighter than the other highlights in the image, and therefore it's not particularly eye-catching. However, the main issue for me is that we've got some duplicate catchlights, which can be a major pain, and the eyes just look a little bit dull. So we're going to do a two-step fix for this. So we're going to repair this eye to remove the secondary catchlight. When the secondary catchlight, if you've not guessed already, was because of a reflector down here, which is giving us light up into this side of the face, the eye, the side of the head, the temples, and of course the bottom of the eye. So that reflector is visible in this eye, but not in this one because it was so far over yonder. Now, to get rid of that and to get a handle on that, there are multiple things that you can do. To be fair, the easiest one I think for this one is going to be a flip job, because the light that was coming in, the main key light up here right at the top, is kind of top down, so it's quite even. So what we can do is we can utilize this eye to help fix this eye, or you could, if you wanted to, just go ahead with a healing brush or a clone stamp and begin to repair it, either or. Do you see? That's really not done a bad job. Okay, so that is another option. Now, let's say for argument's sake, you want to do the other method. That's fine. I'm here for that. We can go ahead and grab our clone source tool, and using the similar techniques to the five ways to remove stuff in Photoshop, which I'll link above, we can go ahead and make sure that in our window tab, we are showing our clone source. Now, our clone source, mine personally, is over here. And with this done, we can then flip by pressing the little flippy buttons here and rotate the clone source. What we're going to do in this instance is we're just going to do a straight horizontal flip, which is that one. And that means that when I pull a sample of this eye from here, I can then dust it over here and it will just immediately copy what's on the other side. So that's done a pretty good job, to be honest. There's very little that I need to do to go ahead and fix that. Potentially take out a little bit, but I've destroyed the eyelashes. Okay, we're super zoomed in, let's go back. Now, destroying the eyelashes is not a big deal really, because I'm on a retouch layer, so I can just go ahead and go up to my history over here, and my history, this is what I've just done, right? But the eyelash was fine in this one, right? So do you see how here there is stuff in that one, but there is not in that one? What I can do is just click the little box next to that line in the history. And then what that does is that gives us our history brush. Now, the history brush only works if you've not changed the state or cropped the image. But what the history brush does do is it will just bring back what was on that layer, this one, and in that specific area. So we can bring back all of that detail, all of those details in the eyelashes through that. Let's go back. Do I have any more? No, there's no more. Maybe a little bit over here. I'll just pull that back. So that gives us a repair job, which, to be fair, is pretty bang on. Now, I'm just going to super quickly go in with a healing brush tool. And because I altered my clone source, I need to go back and just reset that off, because otherwise it's going to be flipping it all the way home. Then I'm just going to go and do a little repair over here, just to make sure that we've still got our continuity, and that is step one. So step one has given us a better eye. Of course, I was using this on a retouch layer already, so it's retouching that side of the eye, but the eyes are looking a little bit dull. What can we do? Well, we've done iris enhancers before on multiple dog edits, but it works just the same. But for humans, we can go a little bit further. So we can go with a curves adjustment layer and do an iris enhance just like we would normally do. Now, that curve is super strong, as we can see, but what we can do is go ahead and switch the blend mode into overlay. Now, overlay will give us a benefit because it adds contrast. So when we invert that, grab a brush And using either your brush and your mouse or a pen and a tablet, you can drop the opacity of that. Let's put the flow up to 100 and let's drop the opacity down to, say, 10. You could leave it the other way around if you wanted to. And then what we want to do, because this is a black mask, is go ahead and paint on it in white. And we can just start to add light. Now we're focusing, if you notice, I'm focusing on the lower side of the iris. I don't want to do the whole thing because it's never going to look natural. So what I'm wanting to do is just focus on the lower side of the iris. And again, lower side, lower side, lower side. Using flow and a pen really does make this a lot easier, but we don't all have access to that. I would definitely recommend going ahead and going over your catch lights as well. Using overlay for this is really nice. And that gives us a little bit of focus. Now let's say, for example, that you have a situation like we have here where there's a little bit of a discoloration, a little bit of jaundice in the eyes, a little bit yellow. Now that yellow, I know because Dan just came off of a night shift, so he's exhausted. But taking that out is quite straightforward. We just use a normal decast method. You don't want to brighten them up too much because it looks, again, unnatural. So we'll grab a hue saturation layer, bring the saturation right the way down to the left, invert that mask, grabbing a brush, and this time maybe 50% opacity. We're just going to go ahead, and 50% is obviously going to be too strong, that's fine. We're just going to go ahead and just paint so that we can see where we're painting. Okay, so we're wanting to just get all up into that area where there was the discoloration there, and we don't want it to be completely black and white because, I mean, guys, nobody's eyes are like this. But what we can do from this point is just bring that opacity back about halfway, sometimes a little bit less. And what that'll do is that'll just take out the discoloration. So if we're looking just here, focus your eyes here. This is after and this is before. After, before, after. So zooming out now, if I go ahead and group these retouch layers together and call them, I don't know, retouch, for example, we've got our original import, the raw file behind, that's before, that's now, before and now. Nice and subtle, doesn't overcook anything, and then when you add your edit onto the top, it all just works together. I hope this video has been helpful for you. If it has, please do let me know. And if you haven't already, please do subscribe. It makes the world of a difference for me, personally. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you all again really, really soon.